us out for either. Then like, if the mother and father care not, I'm done either way. So, okay.
Father, so that God might be taught. We're so glad to have Mr. Teruo Funai be our honored guest today. He's not really a guest, we know him so well. In fact, if you don't know, Mr. Funai has been at this church one of the longest. He's been here longer than you. Mr. Funai is really like the stalwart foundation of this church. He's been the head elder for most of the time the church has been in existence. And we're so grateful, Mr. Funai, for your ministry and leadership over so many years. And we're going to tell a story this morning. Tell a story about this church, how, where it's come from, the roots, and where it's going in the last several years, and hopefully maybe you'll give us some vision for the future. So we thank you so much for your being here. What we're going to do first is show some slides. We're going to put him on the spot because he hasn't seen these slides. And he's going to comment about what the slides show. Is that okay?
Let me say something for you. You know, a well-known performer was introduced. And the introduction must have been something like that. And this is what he says. He says, "I'd like to know who that is because we need more people like that." But we'll see. We'll see what he has in store for us first. Let me say this, though, while we were waiting. Every time I come to church, I say, "Praise God, amen, from whom all blessings flow."
Amen.
And I think we owe him everything.
Amen.
Say a little more before you go. Okay, Mr. Funai, who is this?
Oh, this is
hope we can all see it.
Well, this is a photograph of after we had moved to the elementary school at that time. And depends on which photograph it is. It comes after 1940, 45,
wow.
Maybe after 1950. Mm. But this is, now this is the old termite mansion that we always dubbed it. So it was on the corner of Keaupo and Young Street. And we have to be older than that.
No.
But this is one of the earlier pictures. And
you want to play it? Do we have a stick?
We have a picture that is older, but these two people. That's Dr. and Mrs. James Kuninobu. Dr. and Mrs. James Kuninobu has come back from Japan as medical missionaries. The doctor was a doctor, of course, and Mrs. Kuninobu was a nurse. And the petition, I think this was a general conference for a Japanese-speaking minister, because this...
Get your stick.
This picture. And maybe I have a very, very efficient secretary. His name...
This one?
Oh, okay. His name... You can pass that out now. I have some historical dates. That picture shows Genske Matsuda. Genske Matsuda was the first Japanese Bible worker for the mission. At that time, we were a mission. In 1929, I believe, we had joined the Pacific Union Conference, but we were still a mission at that time. He was a first Bible worker, and he worked with actually young people. So so the Japanese speaking people were a little left on the side. So when Dr. Mrs. Kunirobu came back from Japan, they thought we need a Japanese speaking minister. And that's when Dr. Pastor Shohei Miyake came. This is Yusuke Matsuda, and this is Dr. Mrs. Kunirobu. This is the first minister. So this is a big job. This is 1968. This is the existing building, and this is where we are standing today, sitting today. This is the groundbreaking time I should go back and say that we have purchased this school, or this building, it was called Jackson College, and Jackson College was a Baptist school, and we renovated this, and during the time of our renovation, President Robert Pearson, who was the president of the General Conference, was either on his way to Japan or returning from Japan, and he had been here, so we asked him to do the dedication of this renovated building, not like today, but it was renovated, and also the dedication of the new building, which was still open to the ground like that. And this is the man that sort of spearheaded the whole thing. So Elder Pearson at that time told us that this is the first time he was dedicating a building and dedicating the ground. So that might be some kind of a historical remembrance. But this is Elder Kono encouraging the group from the ground. That is where the building is standing now. Now all of our baptism was done at when it's known as the Diamond Head Church. The Diamond Head Church was the place that we used for our baptism until we had built this church. So this is one of the groups that were some of you may recognize yourself. I only recognize this is Mr. Ishihara, Derek. That looks like Atahori. And this is one of the Inaba girls, maybe. And is you, Sylvia? No. That's not sure. But this is a baptism of it.
Who's that? Yes, sir, folks. Who's that? Mr. Funai.
Don't laugh. You're going to get old. Okay, this is a picture of the drama. This is Pastor Koro. This is Manan Chai, who was the treasurer. This is Ella Streifling, and this is Ella Pearson, Dr. Kuninobu, and Mr. Zane. Walter Zane, who was instrumental in purchasing of this property and so forth. This is a picture of our potluck. Okay. That man there is Judge Alston. An interesting story is that we had plans for that building and it was put out to bid. And the cost came too far beyond what we were able to afford. And so we were sort of despondent. Then Mr. Halstead came just out of the blue. He was an electrical engineer. And he says that you can build this building for about $100,000 or a little over $100,000. And so we invited him to come and talk to us. And no contract, but a handshake. Yes, we started that building. And that was in about 1968. We started the building, and what you see here is because of him. Oh, can we go back to that? Okay. Elder Kono, James Kina, Norman Dima, Mr. Cha, and Mr. Richard Higa. But these people are the ones that really held up the hand of the prophet as we went along. Okay, can we go? When Elder Kono came, we inaugurated camp meeting. And this is one of the pictures from our camp meeting. I think this was at Erdman. And every year we took a group picture like this, and we have several. Incidentally, we would like to have input from you as to where we should put all these pictures. And many people have indicated that the wall against the hall going to the bathroom might be a good place. So, do your input. These are old pictures of all. But I want to tell you something. Many people come to this church to visit. They say, "Don't we heard of your papa?" And I think it credits the diligence of our women, because all during the time of the creation, creation of that building, the ladies provided dinner for us.
Mm.
Okay. This is Mrs. Honolulu. That's Mrs. Chia. That's Mrs. Glenn. That looks like, is that Mrs. Nomi? I'm not sure. Hard to tell. Now, I am not sure, maybe this was when Elder Matsunami was here, but they could have been the Japanese troops together with some of the other people. But Elder Matsunami came from Brazil, and he led the Japanese speaking group for a while. These are pictures of the renovation of this building when we had first moved in.
Who's the lady? Is that Lily? Who is that?
Yeah, that looks like Lily, right?
Lily's not here.
Is Lily here?
She's not here today.
She was always troubled too. Now, I'm not sure where that
is. This is early morning breakfast.
Oh, okay. Okay, that's good. This is Mrs. Yamazaki. These are more pictures of our renovation. This is Michael Yamada. Michael was a very faithful treasurer and part of. This is John. These people comprise a group that met once a week to do small work all around the church. This is look like Robert Makizuru, is that correct?
Yeah.
Yeah. And all these people did small carpentry work, plumbing work, landscaping work, and they did a lot of work, to whom we are very, very fortunate to have that. And this is a picture of more in this corner here. This is Norman and his wife. Still more pictures.
This is distorted. This is a
This is one of the typing ideas.
So who are these people?
Where is the secretary?
Secretary.
Okay.
I got.
Yeah, I made a copy of, do you have it?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'll go back here again. This is against him, not the, then that time Mrs. Kuninobu, who called for Elamiyake, who came and served something like 12 years. And then he was replaced by Elsa Oshisa, who was a teacher at school at that time. Oh, I mentioned Gatling. But he came, and there's another person that came in here, Sakai Kubo, who came and served as pastor while he was in school. And after that, he returned. And then after him came Elder Nomi. Mrs. Nomi here? Okay. Mrs. Nomi and Amy Obata in Honolulu. Probably, I should say, the only two living child members of this church. And that was in 1940 when this church was chartered. So, Nomi is Mel and Joy and Bourgeois father. Okay? Alright. After Elder Nomi left, Elder Kono came, fresh from Sacramento. And he, I'm not sure how many years he stayed, but he stayed
14.
12 years? If you look at your
14.
12, 13 years, somewhere. Okay. But during his tenure, Elder Victor Inoue came. And he was a retired minister, but he worked diligently for the Japanese speaking members. And I'm sure many of you remember that. And of course, after Elder Kono left, then Elder Lau Arakaki came. Very interesting is that after a single man, he had just graduated from Pacific Union College, and he came while Elder Kono was here, and Elder Kono told him this, "Lyle, whatever you do, do not leave me." And in about a year or two, Elder Kono left. And Bob said, "What is this?" But then Pastor Lyle went to seminary. And while he was in seminary, Elder Amon came. And many of you remember Elder Amon. He came. And when he was finished, then Elder Lyle Arakaki assumed his father. But this is roughly the important dates, I would say, in our church up until the time of Elder Pastor Lyle Arakaki. Now, during the time that he was pastor of our church, he was not destined to be single for long. And he was married in our church to Iris Noam. So we had a complete family when he got married. Is there any question you want to ask up until that time? I always wondered, and I'm sure you also, that why you are here. And what is the story on that church? What is the story of this building? And I read a story one time that was interesting. And it says that this visiting a large city that was told that there was a great big construction going on. So he visited that area. And sure enough, he saw a lot of people working, he saw a lot of construction material, and also a lot of bricks. And he approached one of the men, and he said, "What are you doing?" He He said, oh, I'm arranging this. And so he said, oh, okay. So he went to another man and said, what are you doing? He said, oh, I'm getting ready to build a wall. Then he said, thank you, and he moved on to another man and he said, what are you building? And the man looked up in the sky and said, I'm building a cathedral. Now, when I read that story, I thought, that man had a vision. But what about the other two men? And I thought pretty hard about it. But I also thought about all this church. We had these leaders leading us. And what? What about the other people? One child in his class asked the teacher, you tell us about the children of Israel. And what they did. And the child asked the teacher, what were the adults doing? And it was something that wakes you up. And all these leaders, if you really look at it, did not do the work by themselves. And I think you all remember the story in Exodus where the Israelites were fighting the Amalekites. And it says that while Moses held his hand up, the Israelites flourished. When he got tired and put his hand down, it was another story. The rest of us were like the children of Israel. We had under here. We held their hands. And it's a small part. Getting the bricks ready, building the wall, and building the cathedral.
Amen.
Now, Charles Colson is known for his Watergate scandal. And he was asked to do a foreword on a book by Francis Schaeffer. He is there, but he is not silent. And this was either a 13th or 14th anniversary edition of the book. And this is what he said. He said, a prophet is someone who can see things today while the others are blind to it. And these men all saw what was possible here. Not here, we can't say here now, but it started on the corner of Matlock and Keomoku. And from Matlock, he moved to the Makiki Street Elementary School, and then from Makiki Street to here. So it's a progressive thing. And the rest of the story is right in this building and in that building. When we first came to this area, of course this building was here. It was the Cooper Mansion, and it was here, and there was a lot of work. The whole area was filled with trees, and I don't think I remember having a lot of coconut trees around in the area. Now, to me, every part of our renovation of this building and the building of that building has a story. And we were to cut all the trees down. Now, when you cut a tree down, there's a lot of debris. Mr. Gima's brother, Tommy Gima, and many of you heard of Tommy Gima, he was a famous
It's
a race car driver. He was famous for it. But he also ran auto repair and truck firm. And he loaned us his trucks. He loaned us his finger lift and all that. So we were able to take all the rubbish to the dump. And he saved us a lot of money. And that was all because of the goodness of Tommy Gima. And some of the equipment that we use the chain dust and all that to be borrowed by Thomas' brother Norman, who is a member of our church, to cut all the trees because we approach. I'm going to tell this story about Johnny. Right where our entry is now, there was a huge battle. It was really a huge battle. Maybe, what would you say, Johnny, about 12 feet in diameter?
Branches probably covering all the church area.
Yeah, right. And we called a tree trimmer and said that we would like to have the tree chopped. And he looked at it and he said, we're going to cost us $7,000 or $8,000. And now, when he said $7,000 or $8,000, I said, that's just like cutting off our limb. So I said, okay, thank you. So we cut all around the tree. And when we came to the stump, we asked him how much to remove this tree. And he said, well, it's going to take several months because we have to build a fence, put a fire up. But before that, the children, and I said children, and that includes Johnny, they love to play. Say, you know how children are with banyan trees? And they love to play with that tree. And maybe, Johnny, you should come here and tell us that story. But Johnny and his friend used to slide down the tree.
Oh, amen.
And something very different when Johnny came down. And all we could hear was fire! He had some cowboy matches in his pocket. And I thought, but anyway. Tree-trimmer told us that we're going to have to build a fence and start a fire and burn the root out. And I said, well, that's another $3,000-$4,000, he said. So we said, thank you. Then Norman, you come to the victory. But you're going to notice how much we are dependent on one another. The one that's preparing the bricks, the one that's making the wall, and the one that's building the cathedral. Norman's friend said, I'll bring my heavy equipment over. And they were working at the Shriners Hospital down the road here. So one Sunday, he says, I'm going to bring it down, and then we're going to get it out. And I said, well, wait a minute now, how long is it going to take you? He said, it'll take us 20 minutes. I said, now I know you're kidding. And I think Mrs. Kono said, tell me when he starts, because I want to be here. And so he came one Sunday on a big trailer. He brought his heavy equipment, and he was a Caterpillar D8. D8 at those days was the top of the Caterpillars. And, we're running over time. But anyway, with his equipment, he took one, two, three cuts. He turned the tree over. He pushed the stump onto his trailer and took it away. Now these are stories that are involved in the building of that church and also this church. I'm sorry we ran out of time, so I'm going to have to stop here.
I have a question. You asked if anyone has a question. I have a question. I want you to have a seat. Please, have a seat. I have a question. We have a very short film to show you. It has to do with a superhero from the 1960s and his very adventurous group of young people. Okay, so I want you to watch this film and you let us know if you know who this superhero from the 1960s is and this adventurous group of young people. This is at a Pathfinder fair in the 1960s. Down at Thomas Square. This is Japanese church Pathfinders. Where's that little boy? Thomas. Oh, well, I can't see where I'm sitting, but Youth of Today, Leaders of Tomorrow, I think was the theme for that year. This is our booth that we had set up. I think that was Florence, wasn't it?
Christian soldiers marching as to war.
who came and marched with us, and brought their mascot dog with them, the wolfhound. This is all the different Taekwondo groups all around the island. Oh, there's the wolfhound.
I'll tell you that. Look at me. I'm an example. But if you look, if
you look at the sanctuary there, and you look at the ceiling and how it was built, he was one of the main guys that did it. It looks like an upside down ark. So that he's safely taking all of us to our destination, which is heaven.
Amen.
Thank you, Teruo.
That's his humility. That's his humility. Thank you so much, Mr. Funai. And we're going to continue some more of this. There's much more to be told. We'll find the most suitable time to do that. Got to thank Miley, who put that video together part through the night, right? That was a tremendous amount of work from Wayne and Cynthia's old movies. So thanks so much, Miley and Brent, for putting that together. Well, this is the first part of more. We've got to hear from Mr. Funai some more. Thank you so much, and let's separate because I know we're late. Thank you for staying with us so long.